Hey everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Hollow Knight. So I did look around a forgotten or infected crossroads a little bit more, but I didn't really see anything. So I guess it's just gonna stay that way, at least for now. We'll see if I can find the root of the infection somewhere else and maybe root it out there, as it were. However, we are going to look once more, hopefully for the last time, into Fog Canyon. I mean, obviously I might be returning eventually to, look for stuff that I might have missed, trying to fully complete the game, my lady.
Destio, Gio.
No, actually, I haven't really found much need for
Gio,
banking at all. Huh. Is there really nothing else in this room? I guess not. So, yeah, I figured I might as well start my renewed exploration of this place from here. Okay, let's just not bother with those big jellyfish. If I need to, I can kill them outright with a vengeful spirit without having to fear their explodey retaliation. There is a side path here. Okay. There are two paths on the to the top at the top of this shaft. Two at the bottom, which is Bank and Queen Station, and one in the middle to the left. So let's check out the middle one. Oh. Although I think I've already been here. Yeah, definitely. Oh, can I not? Yes, I can. And there was some money up here. Right. So I've definitely been over here. And this leads towards the Queen's Gardens, I guess. In fact, yes. Queen's Gardens. Actually, there was something else I wasn't able to fully check out on my first pass through here. And yes, I'm aware, I'm already in a different area again. Okay, unlock that, it's fine. It's good. What was up here? I know there was this one room. Yeah, exactly. On the left side of this, there is this black barrier. Yes. But I don't need to worry about that because I can just take the way around the right there that I just did. But up here, there was. Wasn't there something still locked? Wait, what was in here? The overgrown mound. Oh god, I completely forget. There are spikes in here. I know I've been here before. This was like a kill room. And I found something here. Was this the upgrade to my magic or something? No, it was something else, but I definitely collected it. Okay. So that's good. This is not even what I wanted to check out either. However, this whole room seems to be, well, I mean, this room. Yeah, this is still part of the same room. Okay, this seems to be part of Fog Canyon, even though it looks more like Queen's Garden. All right, I knew there was something more up here. Oh no, I'm wrong. I guess I had full access to this room already, apart from that black barrier blocking me. Yes, so this is now officially back in Fog Canyon. Wasn't there something up there? I think there's a connection to another room up there. Just kind of annoying to reach, but yeah. Let me go back over here. And think. Oh my god. I think this is the left room at the top end of that first vertical shaft. Will you please carefully make your way up, please? Thank you. Except it's not. Wait. Oh, it might be that I've completely lost track of where I am already. What is this? Is this the room to the left? Yes, it is. Okay. So that means there is something over here. Boy, without a map, it's so easy to lose track of where you are. This is the Queen's Palace. Right, didn't I have to, like, open this up from the side? Wasn't this path entirely blocked before? This should connect over to that passage up there. Well, can't really point at it, in the middle of the screen. That connects back to Fungal Wastes. Maybe I haven't fully explored everything that led up to the Queen's Palace, or not Queen's Palace, what am I saying? Teacher's Archive, right, where I fought Umu and found the first of the big masks. So let's check out this room, I guess. Oh, well, that worked out. Except I didn't expect it to. This might be the room where you first enter from the... this should lead back up to a green path. Yes, exactly. So what's over here? I mean, I'm sure I've entered all of these rooms that are close to... close to the entrance. But then again, Oh, can't go past here. Yeah, I don't think my magic is gonna help me here, unfortunately. Maybe that black stuff is somehow connected to the deep nest or those deep tunnels below that I've also yet to explore. I guess deep nest might be something that I'm expected to explore much earlier, and I've just been holding off on doing so. Right, this place. So I guess I've explored everything that is further to the that is on the left side of Fog Canyon. Yeah. So unless the map is actually past where that archive is, I don't know. I also have already completely forgotten where that was. Up there was, up and to the right was where that barrier was, so it must have been down here. Oh yeah, okay, right, that's on the other side of this room. And I'm pretty sure this used to be blocked off, and I opened it from the other side. Okay, didn't remember that you fell down from here originally. Is there something I can dash to? Oh, yes, there totally is. Okay, cool. That's a nice little secret. Pretty clever. Maybe not so clever, though, because I figured it out pretty easily. Anyway, okay, we got more jellyfish. Got something buzzing. Or is that just the electricity? I thought I saw something crumble from the ceiling here for a moment. Maybe I did, maybe it was just background ambient stuff. Okay, there doesn't seem to be anything in this room. Oh. Yep, I don't know what I thought was gonna happen. So, nothing at the bottom of this. something here. This is kind of hidden, so maybe I missed it on the first go. Or maybe this is the other side of that room with the black barrier. So far, those have often had a way to actually go around. No. Okay. I'm not sure where these overgrown sentries or guards or whatever here before. I guess they must have been. Maybe this is the other side of that room. Don't know why I just walked off there, to be honest. Oh yeah, it is. It totally is. Okay, well, that answers that, I guess. Is there something up there? Certainly something. Can I reach it? I don't think so. Unless I could... I guess I could pogo off of that jellyfish, which seems hilariously unsafe because I'm going to be followed by that freaking explosion. Explodey core. Right away. This does not seem like a safe thing to do. I'm also more than likely to just jump into that little jellyfish. Actually, I don't know, maybe I'm supposed to fall from below, or above rather. Oh, actually I don't have to fear that core at all because it's gonna fall into the acid. So that helps. I did not really seem to gain much height though, and also now everything's dead. Okay, and these big guys only respawn when I rest somewhere, I'm pretty sure. Can I cling to this? Oh, I guess not. Okay, you know what? Before I spend even more time trying to do something that might not even be possible to do, or useful to do, let's return this away and keep climbing this room here. Ah, ouch. Okay, let's go around so I don't have to deal with that electricity crap. There's some explodey stuff in there, but I think that's where I actually came in for the first time. Okay, that kind of worked out. Oh, well, that not so much. Wait, no, I didn't come in here, from here. Maybe from here? There's also a passage over on the other side, I think. Yep, sure enough. Also, many, many more of these freaking electricity jellyfish. I don't like them. So this might lead to the... oh, to more explodey stuff. Actually, I'm pretty sure I've not seen this room. At least it does not seem familiar at all. With more of these explodey eggs. I also couldn't have done anything in here without being able to survive acid. Although then again, I think I needed that to come in into this area from this direction anyway, so never mind. Oh yeah, I've definitely seen that though. There was just some money or something. And this is back here, right? Okay, yeah, I found this way back, but that one room though, I might actually not have explored. So that could be something. I feel like I could be onto something there. Oh yeah, that's nice, since that spell goes through walls, that was definitely worth it. Oh god, yeah, this is definitely new. And I cannot explode those things without blowing myself up. That's what I thought. It's also unfortunate, because that means that I'll have to be super careful and I Well, okay, let's do that. Oh no! That was unfortunate. Yeah, I mean, I really only have so much... God, how do I get through this? I only have so much soul to use magic against these things. Oh god. Okay, this is not explodey. Oh god. Well, rip. This is unsafe. Do I want to try and land in between those? I guess. That somehow worked. Okay. Okay, that would have been bad. No, wait, actually, that's a shortcut. So that's good. What is this? Please be helpful. Charm notch. Oh, well, I mean, it is useful. It's not the map, though. Really, are there... At this point, are there any places left I haven't seen in this area? I'm at a loss, I gotta say. I mean, yeah, don't get me wrong. Charm notch is fine. It's really useful. But, it's definitely not what I was hoping for. There's always a possibility that I'll find yet another entrance to this area, to Fog Canyon, from somewhere else. But at this point, I really don't see where. Pretty close to the entrance there. Huh. Also, I mean, I've been checking back with Iselda constantly, but I have not seen her sell any maps at all. And my understanding was that the maps you could buy from Cornifer out in the field will end up being sold at the shop if you miss him in an area. Now, obviously, since that has never happened to me, I'm not entirely sure what missing him even means. If that means, you know, missing him on your first pass through an area, or basically, it could mean entering his room and not actually talking to him and then moving on. And after, I don't know, a certain amount of time, or maybe immediately, his map would appear in the shop. Or maybe it means, you know, completing an area, quote-unquote, whatever that entails, beating the boss of the area, if it has one, without having picked up the map. But none of that has triggered so far. Maybe now that I've seen all the rooms, well, assuming that I've seen all the rooms, the map might be at the shop. I don't know. It's a faint hope, and I'm not really sure. I don't really expect that to be the case. More likely is that I've just missed a room somewhere along the way. Right, this room that had a tree, exactly. Yeah, I'm pretty much at a loss here. I mean, next up, I guess, is Deep Nest. I'm tempted to actually look up where the map is for Fog Canyon, because, I don't know, it feels like I'm just missing it constantly, and I don't feel like going through there blindly yet again. Because what I just did, I was doing quite systematically, and I don't know, if I missed that one door to that one room, like, every single time I went through there now, chances are slim that I'm gonna just find it again. And, you know, as I just said, I don't really feel particularly inclined to go in there yet again. I don't know. I could also just let it rest for the time being and, you know, just move on. Well, you know what? For the time being, I'm just gonna make my way down to Deep Nest. In fact, I want to check out that little side passage there. above Mantis Village, above and to the left. I'm not sure if I have rechecked that or what was stopping me from exploring that before. So yeah, I'm gonna pause recording and make my way there, and I'll see you in a second. Alright, I am not at Deepnest. I'm on my way. However, a couple things. First of all, it occurred to me that there was that one room in Fog Canyon, of course, where it seemed like I couldn't reach that place. I mean, maybe I could reach it with, you know, some bouncing off enemy trickery, but with those big jellyfish not respawning, that seems unreasonably difficult. So either it's completely optional, or I'm actually going to get some sort of, you know, vertical movement ability, double jump or vertical dash or something. So that is that one place that I can maybe check out later. However, it does seem weird that you would be unable to fully explore that place and gain the map until much, much later in the game. Then there are these things. I found this one and another one somewhere that looks similar, and it almost seems like, you know, you could be able to enter these, but I obviously can't do anything with them. And in this room there is an item I never picked up that is behind a little parkour section. It doesn't seem super difficult, actually. In fact, it's extremely easy. Just requires the dash. It's just a wondrous journal, so yeah. Right, I guess I'm gonna pause again, even though I'm close, but yeah. See you in a second. Okay, so this is the place I was thinking of, and yes, I have been here numerous times now, and only to learn that I can't come from this side, or I need some upgrade that I don't have. So, yeah. But I figured I could go down here and jump down into that big room leading up to Deepnest. However, okay, I could also just jump into the easiest enemies in the game over and over. That's fine as well. No, that's not what I meant though. Okay, this is not where I want to be. Wait. Oh, need to be. Top right. Okay, yes, because I figured that I would, on my first time across, my first time around, first time through Mantis Village, I was like super scared and didn't really take my time to look around very carefully. At least I think that I didn't. So there might be some stuff left to find. Yeah, I was basically super scared of these enemies. They took way more than 2 hits to kill and stuff like that. I'm not sure I had any weapon upgrades my first time through. Okay, I need to kind of relearn how to fight these guys, but yeah, basically they're a joke at this point. So, right. Not sure if I ever explored further this way. Oh, right, there's... Yeah. Okay. Ouch. Didn't mean to read that. There's this door. Although, it's not a door on the map, so I don't know. Maybe it's not a door. Maybe it's just an inscription, actually. Wondrous Seeking Death. Welcome. May you find swift end upon our claws. Yeah, actually, it looks more like a... like just... an inscription. I mean, it looks like a door, but at the same time, I don't know. I don't see a way to interact with it, so it might not be. Oh! I saw the dead one and thought it was an enemy. It hit the actual enemy as well, so that's fine. Maybe I did explore everything that was here, but I guess it doesn't hurt to double check. Right. Well. It is still easy to get hit by these guys, but so long as I kill them in 2 hits. Ah, okay. And then I expect them to move farther forward than they actually do. Right, right, there is a bench down there. It's true. Oh, I did not mean to slide. I wanted to bounce. I was denied. Okay. There's also acid down there, which used to be a problem back in the day. Oh, there are 2 enemies here. That's fine. Let's get hit by both. Oh, just by one. Okay, there's an enemy alive up there. Ah, come on. Right, that leads over there. Right, and that place down there connects to the Royal Waterways. Let's actually rest at this bench, though. Because I don't know if there's a... I have yet to fight a Mantis boss. I got the wall-climbing claw upgrade in this place. What was there to update? Not sure. Well, not this place, but, you know, over in the actual Mantis village, which was a huge upgrade, obviously, one of the most important ones, combined with Dash, I guess. But I didn't really have to do much for it, except just survive Mantis village, which was, you know, a challenge in and of itself, but I obviously didn't have to fight a boss for it. So there might still be a boss around, and it might be in that big room underneath. Right. What's the purpose of this first area? Just some kind of acid lake. I guess it's to ensure that once I go this way... Wait, I guess I needed to dash across. I had the dash at that point, yes. But I couldn't have returned without the climbing claw. So there's that. Actually, I think I might have found everything that was in here. I opened this up. I remember. Okay. You know, that's fine. If nothing else, I unlocked at least one journal entry for these guys. And I'm already at this shaft. And this one I'm sure I didn't fully explore. Although, wait. No, maybe I did. There was some stuff here. A couple of levers that I've already hit, obviously. Okay, so maybe I did find most that was to be found here, if not all of it. Except I did not go to the very bottom of this. Don't need to fight that guy at all. That's good. Oh, okay. Fully expected to get hit there. Heh, I can't do that. Right, this is where I turned around. I wonder what these things are on the ceiling there, below me. Is that some sort of mechanism? I don't know. Yeah, I remember sliding down here and being a little bit afraid of whatever those guys might be. Oh, I can't walk here, so this is gonna open up. Right? Looks like a... Looks like something. Challenge! Do I want to challenge them? Do I have to? I guess so. Mantis Lords! I was right. Oh, and those are just spike pits. I gotcha. Do I fight them one at a time? Out. They have these... Oh, these annoying... scythes that I hate so much. Nope. Okay, and here he starts low. I wonder how much stronger I am than they expect me to be. And whether I can just basically cheese them. Okay. I mean, right now they're cheesing me. Yep, and I'm dead already. Okay. New boss with patterns to learn. Let me make my way back real quick off camera, and I'll try that one more time at least. Alright, I'm back here. As usual, it's unfortunate that you start out with no soul at all, So part of the challenge is to try and get as many, get as much soul before returning as you can. Ah, you have to be really quick here to even get some hits in. Let alone multiple. Okay. Yeah. Nope. Could have gotten in too. That was a low start, high start rather. Maybe I can heal once. Okay. Okay, that was easy. Well, I have to fight. Okay, and now it's the two others at the same time. Oh my god. Oh god, and they still hurt you after you've hurt them. Oh god. And they appear quite randomly, unless they're usually appearing. Oh god! Oh god! What? 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 I would have saved in the middle. No, and I missed, and I'm dead. Oh god! This is so annoying. Okay, it's very much dependent on luck as to where they're going to appear. The first phase can easily be completed without taking any damage. Even by me. So that's good at least. Second phase, I have to get lucky with good patterns. Wait a second. Why? What am I doing here? Don't need to be fighting this guy at all. Okay. Anyway, I'm gonna pause again and try that once more. It seems very doable, but, you know, annoying if nothing else. I would really like to have options. To have opportunities to hit those guys with my spells to deal good damage, but that seems unlikely. I have to mostly rely on my weapons, I guess, on my weapon. So, anyway, I'll see you in a second. Alright, challenge again. Focus during the first phase and hope during the second. Oh, no! Ah, that's not focusing. So I'll need to heal. Okay, that's... Yep. And I got hit twice. Okay, heal. Nope, that was not the right way to react. What was that? Should have actually. That's actually a good opportunity to heal. When he does a low sickle throw. Oh! Like so. Oh no. Oh no! I don't know what I was thinking. Oh! God! Yeah. I'm throwing all over the place. God, no! Yo, that's too fucking slow. Too fucking slow. Okay, actually I can heal after this phase. Which is not ideal. Okay, let's wait here. Oh no, that does hit me. What the hell? Okay, I'm obviously not understanding anything. If we could just keep doing this, that would be nice. Okay. Yes, that works! Oh no! I'm down to one. And I get hit, okay. Let's try that again. Alright, so basically ignore damage in the first phase, so long as I'm not really dying. And heal during the transition. Also, that was extremely unnecessary. Okay. Nope. Well. two hits in that face. Don't be too hasty here. Nice, okay. Heal. They're gonna throw. Okay, how do I deal with that? Like this, okay. Get one hit in. Second hit. Okay, they're gonna do that again. Just do this. No! Damn it. Actually, this is really easy to deal with. Kind of. Always feels a bit sketchy. Okay, I think I hit him there? I'm not sure though. Yep, certainly did. There again, maybe? Nope! Oh, okay. Oh god, no. That move. Oh no! I forgot that they still have a hitbox. After... Oh, and I did it! I think? Heal, actually. Whew! Okay, I've impressed them. Achievement unlocked, respect. Oh god. Heart pumping, good stuff. Yeah, I guess let's check out the official entrance to Deepnest next time. Oh boy. Yeah. Let's end it here. I need to take a few breaths in between. A few breaths? Can you even say that? Anyway. I can't talk anymore. I have to regain my focus. So, as always, I thank you very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, please hit the like button, leave a comment, and I shall see you real soon. Bye-bye.